delighted to present the, our private sector committee, and they individually can tell you who they are and what they represent. And this is the highest spirit of the volunteerism. They represent substantial sums of money and services. Excuse me. This is the president.
I'm devastated.
Thank you all for what you're doing. Believe me.
Mr. President, I want to thank you as well. It's an honor to meet you, and it's an honor to be appointed to this administration.
I'm the president of the Library Advisory Committee. Double day of national presence.
Mr. President, Warner Rapids, 34th committee. See you. I know. Mr. President, I'm Sam Spencer.
Mr. President, he's chairman of the Meritors of Columbia Pictures. Gene Herschel Award winner.
Things go bad in November, Ellen.
President of the Association of Editors and Senior Mr. Works of Marketing. Very nice to see us. Appreciate it.
Very happy to be.
I'm Hyman Brown. We met a long time ago.
Yes.
I'm going to do a series for USIA called Americans All, 52 Half Hour Biographies for Boys.
Good to see you.
Henry Rogers.
All your friends say hello.
Well,
all your friends back home.
Well, give them my best regards. Have you got a script for me?
Love the way
it is.
It's
good to see you.
Mr. President, please, we work at USIA, and I'm particularly glad to please work for you for a long time.
Okay, now we just do it.
Thank you.
Publishing and Word Publishing. It's indeed an honor to present this formal copy of the book entitled Reagan Inside Out. You'll be pleased to know that the book is selling very well and is presently on the Kipling bestseller list. We're delighted to have an opportunity to come and present it to you personally.
Well, I'm delighted also, and I want to thank Bob Schlosser for this and for writing it, because I was just saying to some of our people here, I don't usually read books about me because it's the one friend of mine. This way, I know better. Thank you very much. I'm very pleased to have you.
Perfect.
Thank you.
We're proud to be a part of it.
Yeah.
We're proud of you.
Yes.
Proud of
thank you.
Terrific job.
Thank you.
We know you're a busy man.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. Thank you very much.
Mr. President,
thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks, Michael.
Thank you.
Mr. President,
yes.
This is Howard Bell.
Oh, there.
Mr. President,
I'm glad to see you, sir.
Nice to see you.
Tanya Carvalho is
president of Actu Honolulu of the American Advertising Federation.
Well. And on behalf of Honolulu Actu, aloha, and thank you very much for having me.
Well, thank you very much. I know that goes with
it. That's right. You've had that
I wasn't
before.
That.
That's right. That's the best part. I'd like to meet Holly Stewart, too, Mr. President.
Oh,
this is she's reading that story. She's been with us since the beginning of the Office of Private Sector Initiative.
Wow.
She's our privileged our service. Senior staff person. She's done a great job. She's headed our partnership in education.
Wow. Well, listen, I know what you're all doing for volunteerism, and I just, of everything that's happened in this administration, that's the one thing I'm proudest of, is how many Americans are, the group that just went out of here, is the group that is heading up all the private sector advisors in all the fields of communications and so forth, the Charlie Wicks, the USIA.
Oh, yes, yes, I just saw Charlie on the way out.
And they're everything from motion pictures to publishing.
Doing a fantastic job. The Olympics is coming in next, so you're going to see another great volunteers and experts there.
That's right. Well, the American Advertising Federation has been very much, in the last 2 years, as you know, involved in promoting as a number one program volunteerism and your private sector initiative. And we appreciate it.
Thank you, sir.
Done. We appreciate your leadership.
Dennis?
Hi, how are you?
Fine, thank you.
Mr. President, I'm Mark Lando.
How's it doing? Nice to see you, sir.
Thank you, Mr. President.
So are you. Anyways, thank you for your generosity and sharing him with me.
It's our pleasure. We're so happy to have him as part of our organization. And I mean that very sincerely. He's added a great deal.
I understand that. So
we're glad to have him back, I'll tell you.
There's many thousands
there. And this, first of all, I want to thank you very much for sharing your time with us this afternoon. And this is something, I don't know if you're aware of it or not, the Pacific Telesis Group, probably you recognize that, but that's the successor holding company to the company you knew so well, Pacific Telephone.
Yes.
And what we did, we thought it would be appropriate in our honor to present the commemorative Olympic telephone. We were a little presumptuous, and I think Dennis has to take a little claim for this, of deciding where you're going to put the telephone.
Well,
because what we did, you had your
brand
on the handset. And Dennis said that this might look very well in your TAC group. So, as I said, that is presumptuous, but we hope you can use it in the TAC group.
Very much so, yes. That would be just great there. Well, now this would just be plugged in.
Yeah, it's just a single line instrument. So you can just, Dennis indicated you have it can be done very easily. You just plug it in.
Oh, by God.
And it's all ready to go.
That's just great.
And hopefully it will work well.
It'll get a workout, too, because when I'm at the ranch, I spend an awful lot of time on
the
phone.
I'm sure you do.
Came back stating that presidents don't get vacations, they just get a change of scene.
I think that's probably very well said.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Well, we hope you enjoy it. It's our great honor to be able to present it to you. We hope it receives the use that I'm sure
it will. With the brand.
Well, that was the...
That's what Dennis was doing.
Dennis was the creator of that.
Actually, that shows you which way to hang up the receiver. The arrows have to go up and down.
That's the mouthpiece, I take it, or is that the
earpiece? Yeah, this is the earpiece, this is the mouthpiece.
This is the mouthpiece.
The smaller. And it works. As I understand, at the ranch, you don't need the touchstone pad, but this is a sort of a heat-sensitive pad. Instead of the buttons, you can just touch it. It takes a very light touch, and then that will distribute whatever
signal. For goodness sakes.
And then the clock, you'll also notice that we were provincial enough to set it on California time. I hope it's on
It's on zeros.
The Secret Service did it to us. Depend
on him to get it back.
Right, now we need to give some individual pictures.
Just a couple.
Well, aren't you very thoughtful? Thank you very, very much.
Thank you.
That's just marvelous. Thank you, sir.
Now, so we have individuals?
Yes.
Well, sure.
All right.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Thank you.
This is great.
Thank you.
Okay, Mr. President, let's just...
Thank you.
Good to see you, and to thank you for all you did for Williamsburg.
Well, it was a privilege to do it.
Where's Diane?
Wonderful success, and we're glad that I played a small role in that undertaking.
Yes.
Yeah, this is Diane Powers. Dick.
Hello, Dick. Well, it's nice to see you.
Good to see you.
Hi. I'm excited to meet you. You're taking your own steps.
Yes.
Sorry about that.
I should think of the tires, which is the prettiest picture.
That's super helpful.
I just personally haven't placed my part, but your consideration of the House members deals with some real difficult people, because I'm representing you, and I don't want to do anything else. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Oh, yeah.
Great job.
Thank you.
Good job, please.
Well, thanks.
Well, and I guess you've probably already said happy birthday to him.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
And life does really begin.
Boy, I think so. I'm having more fun now than I was when I was 30 years old. The only thing is that I have more gray hair than you do.
My husband thinks that we might have some common ancestors.
Oh, I thought it was interesting when you were in Ireland in Ballyporeen, the old Farrell pub. My grandmother's name is Mulcahy, and my great grandmother's name is O'Farrell. And I, you know, and they came from, the Mulcahy's came from Cork, and I just. Neat coincidence.
Well, you're going to think that I've invented this, but my great-grandfather, Michael, the one who left Ballyporeen, married a Mulcahy.
Is that
right? Yes.
Well, my father had told me something like that a long time ago. They came from, the Mulcahy's came from the same county in Ireland, but he hadn't had a chance to check it out. So I just thought it was a...
Wait, one second. Just one second. So I can give it a seminar.
Increase revenue by tax reform. So they cut down the tax increase.